Hi, my name's Simon from Motordrome, and today we're going to take a walk around and a drive of this J registration, so either 1991 or 92, left-hand drive Land Rover Defender 110 2.5 diesel that you can see lurking behind me. Two videos, one walk around, one driving, plus a bit of engine running action at the end on both of them. Hope you like them. Okay, let's take a look around this 1991 on a J, Land Rover Defender 2.5 diesel. 110 soft top. It's an ex-military vehicle and it's left-hand drive. Obviously, as you can possibly see, it's got things like rather a large suspension lift on it. I think it's lifted by about 4 to 5 inches over standard. It's also painted in what I think is Raptor black. It's certainly matte black, and it's a rough to the touch finish. So I've not come across Raptor before. I know a lot of people talk about it, but I haven't seen it before. But I guess this is a Raptor finish. I don't know. It's certainly, as I say, rough to the touch. It's also got some very deep dish steel wheels on it. It's got steering guard, factory steering guard, military front bumper, but with A-bar on it, and this sort of custom light and grill arrangement, which again I haven't seen before. I think we're told this one's spent a lot of time in the Middle East, but I did find some paperwork inside suggesting it come from Hungary. So it is now fully UK registered and what have you. Decent quality mohair soft top. Not sure if it's Exmoor trim or not. As I say, deep dish steel wheels. Spare wheel carrier, although we don't have a spare wheel for it, but you'd be unlucky to get a puncher in those, it's fair to say. NATO tow hook, extra sort of underride bar on the back of it, rear light guards, and full length side runners. And we've also got, last but not least, extended arches and snowcowl, and also this rather strange sort of custom bonnet arrangement on it as well. Inside, it's at the moment it's a strict two-seater. The back is completely bare. The seats are not Land Rover seats, and actually they don't match. That one's got checker on it, that one's got stripes. Not sure what they're from, but they're actually quite comfortable. But really, you know, the interior is the bit that needs a bit of work. It's lost its cowl for the steering column, but that's not difficult to get, and really those seats. But anyway, let's walk around and pick out some other bits and pieces on it. We'll start around the front here. Originally, I think it was white. It is an ex-military one, but I think it's probably an ex-NATO vehicle, this one. Let's have a look under here, so you can see what sort of state the chassis is in. Here on the bonnet, on the scuttle corners, a little bit of reaction around there, but otherwise all looks pretty good. A post. Let's have a look at. It's got civilian doors on it though, rather than military doors. Strange. Door bottom on this door actually feels to be in quite good shape. It is, there's a bit of a line of corrosion there, which is clearly coming from somewhere here, but it's not, I can't feel it at the moment. Look at the side of the bulkhead up there, and what we can see underneath. And then, let's see if we can pull this out so we can see the footwell. Not sure we can. Oh, yes we can. Driver's footwell. Put that back on properly in a minute. Otherwise, so interior-wise, the seats are cloth, but they're not proper Land Rover ones. We don't have a battery cover for it underneath there. It's showing just under 28,000 kilometres. How genuine that is anybody's guess. We're not going to make any pretenses to know. It could be, but who knows. offside, well, near side rear wing, all pretty good. Let's have a look under here. The tail end, get down and show you the back face of the cross member. Looks pretty straight down the offside there. And again, underneath here. So we've got a little bit of corrosion in the cross member just at the back there. The rest of the chassis looks pretty good under there. Snow cows on, and again we'll have a look under here. And then inside here, again, door bottoms on this side feels pretty good. So look at the bulkhead at the side there. Under there. Let's have a look at the footwells if we can get to it. Footwells look to be reasonable as well. So, there we have it really. I can't tell you a lot about it, where it's come from. It is what it is, but it's an interesting vehicle. Anyway, my name's Simon. You can reach me in the office on 0118 907 1495. Or you can go to our website, which is www.moto-drome.com. Okay, quick video start up and running on this 2.5 12J engined Land Rover Defender 110. All light ignition light come up as they should, as does the low fuel light, although the fuel gauge doesn't seem to be working. Starts cleanly whether it's hot or cold, in fairness. You move out to under the bonnet. Here we have a 12J engine. 2.5 normally aspirated. Standard 50 military defenders, if you say. Goes on forever. And this one just chugs along, like they always do. There we have it.